Hi, my name is Kennedy and I'm from the Patricios. My question is for both of you, and it's what do you hope kids and families take away after watching this movie?
I would say that, you can find the heroism in your parents and what they go through and how much effort they put in. And so, and also, for someone like Ken Sato, who didn't want to be a parent, discovers the importance of that responsibility. And I think within that is the message of Ultraman as a hero and to aspire to rise up and take on that occasion.
And for me, I hope that if there are times when parents and kids aren't talking or where they have difficulties, they have arguments, that maybe they'll watch the movie and they'll think about that and want to reconnect and pick up the phone and say, "Hey, do you want to come over? Let's have a chat." I've gone through that with some family members where, it's just natural. You love each other, and with love comes passion, and out of that sometimes comes frustration and conflict. But being able to be open and thoughtful, and being able to say, "I'm sorry." And so I hope the film encourages that.
Thank you.
I'm partnered with the Patricios, and was there any room for improv for the cast, or did you have to stick to the script?
Improv. I would say when we had Christopher Sean and we were, doing takes of all the fun stuff like, drinking coconut water and describing what it might taste like.
Yeah, we went off on a tangent on the whole taste like a fart bit, and had a lot of fun with that. But what I like to do when directing actors, I'll say, like, let's do the line as I've written it. Let's give it a shot. Let's try it. Let's find nuance in it, and let's come up with your own. Let's give what are your ideas? What are your thoughts? I really like to collaborate. And animation is the ultimate collaborative medium. So you want to leave room for that.
Are there any highlights or fun memories while filming that you could share?
When you're in a position like this and you can just kind of think out loud and things happen, for example, we have this amazing guitarist, Tim Henson, who plays with the band Polyphia. And Tim is just one of the most talented guitar players in the world, and I love the band Polyphia, and I just threw out to our composer, I said, "Hey, what if we got Tim Henson to play on the score?" And he goes, "Yeah, let me think about that." And we got Tim Henson to play. And like being able to do something like that, I have to remind myself that's not normal to be able to do that. But when you work on a big project like this with Netflix and Tuaraya, you get to do those things and you kind of get really giddy. And then when Tim came into the studio for the first time and was playing guitar and we heard his music for the first time, that was a pretty incredible experience.
For me, I would talk about my cast because, Geddy, Tamlin, I grew up watching them, and then Christopher Sean is amazing, and we become friends, and Christopher is like a super sweet, real, like I call him Ultraman because he is a very genuine person. And so you meet great people like that. Even Keone Young, our villain, and he was a voice of Storm Shadow in G.I. Joe, which I grew up watching. And so I'm just like nerding out on all this stuff. And so it's always great to connect and work with your heroes.